If you're just getting started in TRACKTION Waveform 10, you might be wondering how to install VST plugins in Waveform 10. I'm going to go over that in this video. Welcome to Simple Green Tech, where we do tips, tutorials, and reviews to help you unleash your creativity. If you'd like to see more videos like this one, including more TRACKTION Waveform 10 videos, please consider subscribing to the channel. I'm Radio Zane, and in this video, we're going to be looking at installing a VST plugin and getting it to work in TRACKTION Waveform 10. So let's get started. First, let's download a plugin to install. I highly recommend Plugin Boutique for plugins, as they have free plugins, and you can also grab premium plugins at a greatly reduced price. I've linked to them in the description below, just in case you want to see what kind of sales they have today. So I've downloaded the plugin that I want to install. In this case, it's the Synsonic BD808 Drum Machine plugin. This is free on Plugin Boutique. If you want to grab it, you can. So what we first want to do is unzip this. And once it's unzipped, click on the installer. We're going to use the 64-bit installer because that's what this system is. Now this is what you want to look at right here, the destination folder. So this one wants to install in C, Program Files, Steinberg, VST Plugins. That's fine with me. That's one of the standard folders that plugins tend to install to. So I'm just going to hit install. But if you had a different folder where you want plugins to be installed, you can select that one. Now it says the plugin has been installed, so we can close the installer. Now we'll open up Waveform, and we're going to go into Settings. You then want to go down to the Plugins tab, and here we're going to click on Scanning and Sorting. We're going to scan for new or updated VST plugins, and you can see here I have folders already in there, but if I didn't have these folders in there, I would click on this plus sign, and we know that we just installed it to the C Program Files Steinberg VST Plugins folder, so we would go through this menu and find that there's Program Files, Steinberg, VST Plugins. And we would click OK on that. And you can do that for whatever plugin folder you want. The ones here, C Program Files VST Plugins, that's a common one. And C Program Files 86 VST Plugins is also a common one. So you may want to add those folders if you don't have them already. And once you do have all the folders that you want to scan, just click the scan button. And sometimes you get this message that says the following appeared to be plugin files but failed to load correctly, and it might list some there. I always hit OK, and those plugins always show up for me. So I think what those are 32-bit plugins, and this system only wants 64-bit plugins. So now we'll look for the plugin that we just installed. Make sure it's in this list. There it is, the Synsonic BD808. So we know that it's installed properly and we're ready to go. So let's start a new project. We're going to right click over here and add a new plugin. So we know it installed to the Steinberg VST plugins folder. There it is there. Click on it, and we now have our BD808 drum machine loaded up. Let's hear how it sounds. So what we'll need to do is add a MIDI clip to the track. And to do that, you can drag this plus sign down into the track. Let go of the mouse. It's going to ask you what type of clip you want to insert. So we're going to be inserting a MIDI clip here. And there you have it. You should now have a successfully installed VST plugin, and you should be able to use it on a track, plus use a MIDI clip to control it. Now, if you wanted to add any other effects to this, you could just right-click over here, add new plugin. We'll add a compressor plugin. And you want to make sure that comes after the instrument. So you just drag it over to the other side of the instrument. We will choose a preset here. We might as well go with drums because this is a drum. And Let's hear what that sounds like. Let me know in the comments below what plugin or plugins you plan on using in TRACKTION Waveform 10. You can also let me know if you have any other questions about this great software. Thank you so much for checking out this video. If you'd like to see more videos like this one, including more TRACKTION Waveform 10 videos, please consider subscribing and hitting the thumbs up button on this video. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Radio Zane, and we'll talk soon.